Hello again. I'm working here with Prendar, who has struggled with being in this space and just emotional wellness, emotional regulation. I started with working on building some communication, building a language of touching, so that I have some place to start each day. You know, if I touch here, if I touch here, then we have a clear message between one another. If I touch here, I'd like to go over here. Good. In breaking down with him what bothers him, what I usually like to do is try to either add or eliminate one thing at a time. Something that is very interesting with him that I have noticed is that he is more up in his emotions and wants to be further away from me, just for fun, than if I take the rope off. So to get to the place where he has been more able to keep working, keep learning, I got to that place through the access portal I had, which was taking him offline. Hi, bud. And everything just slows down in his mind and his emotions. He just kind of goes, oh, well, this isn't so bad. If you watch the previous video, the presentation of the right side is kind of an interesting phenomenon. I know that was your friend, wasn't it? Yeah, he tends to stay closer at hand when I ask him to move. Hi. There we go. Good. Want to come on around? Good boy. And since he doesn't feel super safe in the space, I don't mind if he drifts. Because that... Good. Yeah. Can we go the other way? No, it can be harder. It can be harder this way. Good. 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 Nice boy. Good. Good boy. Yeah. So, liberty is how I kind of snuck in the window to build some connection, but I also know that he needs to feel safe and confident online. So even right there, he's more reactive online to noises and his surroundings, and so that's where I'm trying to help him to be more confident would be a word, more settled, clear that this is not a, yeah, this isn't a bad way to communicate with a rope. And the feeling that we can get through a rope. So he's starting to show nice processing earlier and earlier in the session. Since he does tend to rush, I showed him, you know, some more like I go, you go, I stop, you stop, but I had to do it in, of course, a very polite way so I didn't ramp up his emotions because, you know, he already is dubious about the whole thing. So I want to teach him in such a way that the doubt turns into clarity. Oh, I know. The girls are cleaning stalls outside. That's a lot, huh? Something else I've been working on with him is more of what I would refer to as academic lunging. So I want him to understand to step out to contact with the line. Because liberty is good. It's a good activity. But I want to be able to support him on these circles. That's nice. And because this is a heavier rope and not a lunging ribbon, there's going to be some drape. And he's also in a rope halter instead of a cavesson. So we have to be mindful of the products that we're using and how much is he going to feel with that product. With a cavesson, I would probably want him showing quite a bit of contact with the rope, not as much with a rope halter, because he can definitely feel that. Good boy. Super boy. Oh, goodness. That's a lot, huh? This way. There we go. And again, out to the contact. This also helps him not to lean in and be less balanced. There, I like a little bit there, flexion to the inside, if I can have it. Nice rhythmic tempo, very good. Oh, give me a little more. There you go, good. The next thing I would like him to start to learn is that if I hold pressure on the line, yeah, I'd like him to extend his neck a little bit. Out you go. Little pressure on the line. Little tiny neck extension. Good. Out you go. Pressure on the line. Little tiny neck extension. Good. He still gets pretty, insides get pretty escalated when I canter him. Still, and some of that is balance and some of that is just things coming at him faster. Again, he's showing some emotional discomfort, shifting around to a position that he feels more comfortable being around me in. Observe. He's still quite aware of what's going on. Maybe we can just do a little bit of canter, not enough to upset him. Canter! Canter! Got a little Pepe Le Pew action going there. There we go. That's a bit of relaxation. And I'm going to let him trot it out a bit. See if we can get back to that quieter place. Stay out, please. For real. Thank you. If he wants to walk in here at any given time, that would be fine too. It takes quite a while for him to settle after cantering, which is why sometimes I choose not to. In fact, I probably won't canter him the other way. That is not out to the contact. You see, we've lost quite a bit of what we had put together by sending him to the canner. So it's not a bad thing. It's just something to notice in my daily work is if I ask him to do X, Y, Z, what's it going to cost me? You know, is it going to cost me some calm? Is it going to cost me some relaxation? What's it going to cost me? There we go.